Do you have excessive hair growth, or called differently, hirsutism, and you don't know why it happens and what to do about it? Stay tuned, because I'm going to be talking about why hirsutism happens and what we can do about it. If you haven't seen my previous video about hirsutism and PCOS, please make sure you check it out and you check out my other videos about insulin resistance. Now, I feel that I probably didn't explain everything as much as I would like to, so I will be talking a little bit more in depth about it today. Now, I was talking about hirsutism and PCOS because my channel is about PCOS and hirsutism. So in our case, very often what comes first is PCOS, then it comes insulin resistance, and insulin resistance actually causes our ovaries to produce excessive amount of androgens, which then can cause stuff like hair loss, acne, and hirsutism, and excessive hair growth in places that are normally associated with male hormonal profile, like very often in our chins, on our bellies, back, bumps, chests, and so on. So why does it even happen? As I mentioned to you before, very often what happens is when we have insulin resistance, our ovaries are stimulated by insulin to produce a lot of testosterone, which then in turn get to our follicles, and follicles start to overproduce testosterone. Now, it's the same thing with actually hair loss, because if you have noticed, many men after a certain age, usually after 30, have the same thing, that their surge of testosterone causes the hair loss on their heads, but causes hair growth on their chins. So this is exactly the same process that happens with women in PCOS. However, hirsutism can also be caused by abnormal testosterone levels from different causes. So sometimes it's also caused by genetic predisposition, but most often it is caused by high androgen levels that can again be caused from different issues. So as I mentioned, first thing was insulin resistance that causes our high androgen levels. Second thing might be androgens, so our high levels of adrenal androgens. So what they do, it is called the most common hormone is called DHEA, and of course there are a few variations, both of testosterone and DHEA, which can actually cause excessive hair growth. So again, high levels of DHEA may cause your extensive hair growth. So what happens very often, and what I found on certain forums, for example on Facebook, with women with PCOS, most often what happens is with high insulin resistance levels, there are many women that are, for example, obese and have problem with weight gain, and at the same time they struggle with excessive hair growth. So this is the most common thing, right, with insulin resistance. But we have this other group of a lean PCOS that still struggles with hirsutism and still struggles with acne and hair loss. And this is the other way. This is very often caused by high DHEA levels. So this is also something that is worth exploring, because many people say, okay, I don't have insulin resistance, but I still have excessive hair growth. This might be also hyperandrogenism, but different types of androgens. It's the same with acne. Sometimes you might have high testosterone levels that's actually causing your acne, and sometimes it might be stress and stress hormones. So it's very important to observe your body whether these types of stuff actually get exacerbated in periods of stress, or maybe in periods when we eat more sugar and stuff like that. Now, there is a third group that I briefly heard of, so correct me if I'm wrong, but I have also heard that sometimes for some people there is problem with conversion of testosterone to dehydrotestosterone, if I'm gonna put the name here. So for that we have specific supplements as well, so it's the problem with conversion of certain hormones in our body, so this can also be an issue. And sometimes just taking a supplement might actually aid that. Now, what are the treatments for hirsutism? First of all, birth control pill can help tremendously, but again, as I mentioned in my previous videos, it is a very short-term solution, because as soon as you stop taking it, it might come back. Second thing will be spironolactone, that is the most common thing that actually is usually used when birth control pill doesn't work itself. So spironolactone you have to always take with birth control pill, because otherwise if you would have gotten pregnant, it can actually hurt the fetus. So spironolactone is a little extra on top of birth control pill if birth control pill itself does not work. But again, it comes with a lot of side effects, as well as birth control does, so this is something that you might consider yourself. Another thing is changing the diet and lifestyle, and this is something I'm a big proponent of. And as I said before, especially if you have an insulin resistance kind of hirsutism, yeah, so it is caused by high insulin levels that then convert into testosterone, lowering your insulin levels will do huge difference. And most of us with PCOS have that exact problem. So for myself, for example, I had to go all the way keto, but for some people going with a whole foods diet and actually changing to, I don't know, even from eating, white rice, or even from eating buns or bread to rice or to chickpeas will make a tremendous difference, and just eating whole foods. However, for others, maybe cutting carbs completely, like in terms of keto, might be the option. Make sure that you check the diet for PCOS video when I'm explaining it a little bit more. And the last type is gonna be the adrenal type. So of course, if you have adrenal type, you might think about also different lifestyle changes, as in reduction of stress and so on. But make sure that you check my playlist, they are talking about that, because there's plenty of information about that there as well. So make sure you check my other videos, and make sure you check my Instagram, because I bring a lot of value there in a lot of graphical posts as well. And make sure you like, subscribe, and click the notification bell to be notified about my future videos. And I will see you very soon. Bye.